Welcome to biology class. In the unit reproduction, we completed human reproduction and reproductive health. Now we're going to proceed with the first chapter, reproduction in organisms. Chapter 1, reproduction in organisms. So first, what is reproduction? Reproduction. So it is a biological process in which an organism giving birth to the young ones. So in this chapter, we're going to cover the topics are lifespan, definition, function, types of reproduction. So here in this topic, we're going to discuss about two types. One is asexual and other one is sexual. With example and with a diagram, we're going to discuss more about that. And last, we're going to discuss about events in reproductions. Lifespan. So in this topic, we're going to study about the lifespan. What is this actually? Each and every organism can live only for a certain period. So that period we're going to calculate from the birth to the natural death. So lifespan is defined as period from birth to the natural death. Okay, so it may be vary from species to species. Another point, a death of every organism is certain. So the birth period and death period will be different for all the particular organisms. So here I just given you the examples. So lifespan of a few organisms, here I just denoted. Banyan tree, 200 years. Parrot, 140 years. Man, 100 years. Butterfly, 1 to 2 weeks. Mayfly, 1 day. So it might be differ like 5 years or 10 years once we consider this lifespan. Between these two extremes or the lifespans of most other living organisms, you may note that lifespan of organism are not necessarily correlated with their size, because the size of the crow and parrot are different. Even though we were including that into the bird category, but the size will be differ. The species will be differ. So every organism show different lifespan. Reproduction. It is a biological process in which each and every organism give rise to a young ones. That is the new individual, new species. So whatever you want to, you can say, you can say. All these only happen by the process called reproduction. It plays a major role in the life process of each and every individuals. Here I want to discuss about the two terms. One is oviparous, another one is viviparous. Oviparous are considered to be the egg-laying animals. Viviparous, the animal which giving birth to the young ones. Both are phenomenon only done by the life process called reproduction. Okay, so there will be like again it producing the own species, the own character which is expressed in the upcoming species are called reproduction. So it is the biological process in which each and every organism give rise to the offspring. So offspring is nothing but the young ones or progeny. So whatever the term you want to call, you can be say to offspring, progeny or young ones. So it is similar to the itself. It means the parents. Okay, every offspring will be resemble like a parent, whether it is a type of asexual or sexual. Asexual, it means for like actual copy of the parent will be exhibit. But in asexual reproduction, there will be the involvement of two gametes, male and the female. So there will be the variation will be there. Okay, so that and all we will be discuss elaborately in upcoming topics. So now, what is this offspring? Offspring want to grow, it want to mature, and in turn it produce new offspring. So it might be like the connection, it might be goes on like generation to generation to generation. For example, your grandfather, grandmother, next is your mother and father, and next is you, and next is your generation going to be continue. So there will be the future generation only continue with the help of this life process called reproduction. Now we're going to discuss about the importance. Why we need this reproduction? Yeah, it is a very necessary to the continuity of the species. If it is the male and the female partner were producing a new offspring, so there will be the continuity of the generation to the generation to the generations. So there will be the a character which resembles like inheritance. So there is a lesson called heredity, the transformation from the one character to the other character. So it will be like carried over from one generation to the next generation by genes. So it all becomes under aridity lessons. For all this thing, the base will be reproduction. So it is the continuity of the species. So this life process will be like in future generation also, it will be continuity. It is also responsible for variation in a population and an inheritance to future generation. Yes. See, for example, if you take as example as a dog, so dog itself, you will be seeing many varieties, types of reproduction. So the types of reproduction are two types. They are two types. What are they? Asexual. So these are the two types of reproduction. One it is asexual, another one is sexual. So here the A, it refers to absent. Okay, so what does it A refers to? Absent. So there will be the absent of sex. Okay, so there will be the involvement of male and the female gamete. Actually, it not present in asexual. So sexual reproduction. So now we will be discussing as like a points. So first point. So when the young ones are produced, so it will be only formed by the formation of gametes. Okay, so here sexual reproduction is meant for formation of gametes. Formation and fusion of gametes. But here in absence of sex, what happened? There will be no cause for the formation. So no formation and fusion occurs in asexual reproduction. Second one, the offsprings are produced. Okay, so there will be like genetically character which is identified or not. Okay, so second point which deals with that. So genetically identified. So here will be one of the important points we're going to discuss in detail about the clones, because clones is an actual, the exact copy of the parent. So the genetically identified clones, okay, will be produced in the asexual type of reproduction. Here genetically it not be identified. So no genetical, but it exhibit variations because there will be the formation of and fusion of gamete occurs automatically. What happened? So there will be the sharing of 50% from the mother and 50% from the father chromosomes. So automatically, obviously, there will be, it shows variation. Third point. In asexual reproduction, only uniparental. It shows uniparental types of relationship. Here it is biparental. So the term uni, it means single parent. So only the single parent will be producing the copies. So there will be the multiple copies which will be produced in asexual type of reproduction, whereas in sexual type of reproduction, so it involves the bi, it means two. So two parents are involved. So one it is male, another one is female. Okay. So these are the both the parents where which will be involved in the formation and fusion of gametes to produce a new offspring. So here, the process when we are discussing, it will be like fast process. But when you discuss about the sexual, it will be showing the slow process because the morphologically and genetically the characters are different. Because it want to show the variation. So the process will be very complex. Okay, there will be the elaborate process to be at work. And it is very, very complex to be. So here the process will be referred to the slow process. So this is all about asexual and sexual reproduction. Again, I want to repeat all the point. No formation and fusion occurs in asexual. Here in sexual, formation fusion of gametes will be occurring, genetically identified, and hence we will calling that as like a clones. But here in sexual, there will be like no genetically identified character, but it exhibit, it shows the variation. Here it acquires the uniparental types of relationship. Here it shows the biparental. So the bi, it refers to the female and the male, where the female gamete and the male gamete will be the formation and the fusion of the thing to form a new offspring. And here the process will be involved as fast process. Here will be slow process. Here the multiplication will be like very, very fast to produce the new copies. But it will be like very, very elaborate, complex and slow process will be done in sexual reproduction. So this will be the difference between asexual and sexual reproduction. Elaborately, we're going to discuss about a type, one it is asexual reproduction. So here it is uniparental with or without gamete formation. Yes, offsprings are exact copies or clones of each other. Mitosis is very essential mode of asexual reproduction. Why? Why there is a process which is involved called mitosis? So mitosis in cell division. So the cells divide rapidly. Multiplication of cells will be like very, very fast process. Okay. So the mitosis process will be happen in the mode of asexual reproduction. Now, types of asexual reproduction. Types of asexual reproduction. Very important one mark. So it will be asking in a 2 marks. So kindly listen. Types of asexual reproduction. So the first type, budding. Second one, fragmentation. Third one, vegetative propagation. Fourth one, spore formation. Okay, so the types of asexual reproduction: budding, fragmentation, vegetative propagation, spore formation. Okay, and next one will be fission. And last one will be regeneration. So these are the types of asexual reproduction. I will repeat again: budding, fragmentation, vegetative propagation, spore formation, fission and regeneration. Now we are going to discuss more about budding, fragmentation, vegetative propagation, spore formation, fission and regeneration. So next one is budding. So in the asexual reproduction, the first type we are going to discuss is about budding. So budding, one or more outgrowths are called buds. So which is produced where initially remains attached to the parent cell and eventually get separated from it and grow into a new individual. So in this diagram you can see, so this diagram is about yeast, okay? So this diagram is about the yeast cell. So this is the parent cell of the yeast. So in the diagram B you can see, so there will be like small outgrowth, okay? So there will be like small protrudes, okay, near this. So there will be the full involvement of process, that is the mitosis. So the nucleus getting dividing. So it started to replicating, multiplying it. Okay. In third stage, you can see this buds. So the attachments, okay, which remains to the parent cell eventually get separated. So this will be in fourth stage. So this outgrowth buds will be like growing little bit higher. And in D1, you can see, so automatically this stage is detached from the parent cell. So now this is called new individual. So this is called offspring. So for the budding process, the pure example is yeast. So next we're going to discuss about another example called Hydra. So Hydra, you can see it will be like, it bears lot of the tentacles. Okay. So this is the diagram of Hydra. So in Hydra, so this is the parent Hydra. So it comes under the phylum Coelenterata, where the coelom is actually present into it. The true coelom, which is exhibited in the phylum Coelenterata, the pure example of Coelenterata is Hydra. So in this Hydra, here you can see there will be like small outgrowth, okay, in this region. So this outgrowth will be later on like growing. So this is the body of Hydra, parent Hydra. So this outgrowth, later on it's growing. So next stage, what happened? So from the parent cell, okay, this is a rough diagram of Hydra. So from the parent cell, the budding, the new Hydra is detached. So this will be the formation of new Hydra with the tentacles. Okay, so this process is completely called as budding. Next, second type is about binary fission. So the term fission, it means splitting. Okay, so the binary divides into two. By it means two. So splitting of a parent cell into two or more daughter cell, each of which rapidly grows into an adult. So it mostly occurs in single-celled animals like a bacteria and protozoan. Okay, so bacteria and protozoans are unicellular organisms. So protozoa, proto it means prime, zoa it means animal. So the prime animal, which shows the unicellular type of organization. So it can be very simple or irregular, longitudinal, depending on the plane of division. So here you can see the example, here I just denoted as amoeba. So amoeba, it is a unicellular organism where the nucleus, which plays a major role for the next generation, because the nucleus is getting divided. Okay, so in this diagram you can see the nucleus getting divided by the process called mitosis. So mitosis is nothing but cell division. So here in this diagram you can see the cytokinesis process will be taken places. Okay, so the equally nucleus and cytoplasm will be transmitted to parent cell as well as the daughter cell. And now you can see the youngest one. Okay, so two cells, which shows the parent clones. Okay, it will be shown as a parent clone, and this is a daughter cell. So with the help of one parent cell, we are getting two daughter cell. So 1 + 1 = 2, so that it indicates the binary fission. So there will be the splitting of organization. Okay, so the splitting molecule, we will call that as the binary fission process. Students, in this class we discussed about lifespan, definition of reproduction, types of reproduction, and in the type of reproduction we were discussing detailed about asexual reproduction. So we were discussed about budding and binary fissions. In upcoming session we're going to discuss more about fragmentation, spore formation, vegetative propagation and all. Thank you.